I just got my eyebrows threaded like 20 minutes ago. Went to the mall and I was like, you know what? I'm gonna get my eyebrows threaded. And she threaded them too thin, so that's how we're gonna start off this video. But anyways, today we're here to discuss, not really discuss because I'm the only one in the room, but today I'm gonna share with you guys like a 2018 sneaker recap. So we're gonna go through my top four. I know it's weird, people usually do like top three or top five, but I'm gonna go with top four and go through your guys's top five sneakers for this year. So I actually went on Instagram, put up a question poll thing, and I asked you guys what you thought were the top five sneakers for 2018. So starting off, your guys's top five sneakers for 2018 are the Union and Jordan Brand collab Jordan 1s. Here they are. I don't really know what to say about these because I didn't really like them, but it was on your guys' list. So next on this list are the Travis Scott Air Force Ones. I think these were dope. Moving on, the third one on this list is the Nike Element React 87s. I think that's the name of the shoe, but these are sick, and I have yet to cop myself a pair. I really like the OG colorways, the sale, and the black. I haven't been able to find them. I didn't even know that they dropped in Canada. Being a female sneakerhead in Toronto, it's not very fun because most places don't stock your size. Everything's already super limited and it doesn't come in smaller sizes. So anyways, in the near future, I definitely would like to cop these. Moving on, the Off-White Jordan 1s. I think the Off-White Jordan 1s were people's top sneaker for 2017 as well as 2018, and I'm sure it's gonna carry over into 2019. So let's see what Virgil and Nike are gonna do for the next. Last but not least, the 500s. You know, I love 500s. Great shoe, very comfortable. For our runner-up spot were the Fila Disruptors. Now, I was actually pleasantly surprised that a lot of you said this was part of your top five sneakers of 2018. Truthfully, I have a pair. I've had them for a while now. I didn't really get the chance to wear them that much. I definitely saw the increase in popularity for the Fila Disruptors. They're very inexpensive and everybody had them. Their mom, their uncle, their sister, their brother has these. I swear I saw a lot of people in 2018 sporting the Fila Disruptors. So I think that's a solid runner-up. Starting off my list are the Travis Scott Air Force Ones. I like these. I really wanted them. I got them for a good price, and they were dead stock. However, the canvas material creases like a bitch, as well as they get dirty and I don't know how to clean them. But overall, dope shoe. I like the concept. I like the sale colorway a lot more than the white pair that he came out with. So on my pair right now, I have like the brown tortoise check as well as the silver one on the inside. Really like the gum bottoms. When I wear it, I actually take the little patches off. It's just a little bit too much for me, so I've worn these a few times. They have already creased, not very badly, but it still annoys me. I feel like creasing on leather looks nice, but creasing on canvas, not so nice. But yeah, coming in at the number four spot. So number three on my list are the satin shattered backboards. I went crazy for these. I needed them. I had to have them in my collection. Didn't matter what I had to do to get these, I was gonna have these and I needed them. And there's a funny story behind this, guys. So I don't really want to get into all of that right now, but yeah, coming in number four, clean shoe. I also bought these off of a subscriber. He was super nice. We met up, he sold them to me for a really good price as well. Like, he was super cool and super nice. It was really kind of him to sell it to me for very, very close to retail, so I really appreciate that. Coming in at number three. You guys are not going to expect this from me, or maybe you are. It's weird. I don't think it hit anybody's list this year, but the New Balance 990s. and I've been eyeing these for a while now, and I actually recently caught them on Boxing Day, so I got like a decent deal on them. But these are just so comfortable. It's so weird, I know. So weird, because usually these lists are filled with hype shoes of 2019, but this shoe is really underrated. I love the dad shoe trend, and honestly, these go with so much. I love these. I want more colorways, but yeah, number two spot on my list. Coming in at number one, can we get a little drum roll? Fuck it, I have hands, but I'm sure I could edit a little drum roll in there. The Yeezy 500. So I'm actually really happy that this made your guys' list as well, because I don't care. Like, this is my sneaker of the year. So I had the blush ones first. Look at these guys. Like, you can see how beat they are. Like, I need to get another pair. So if anybody's selling the blush 500s in a size 6, hit me up. In Instagram, DM, comment, Facebook, Snapchat, Twitter, I don't know, message me, because I need another pair. Look at that, guys. Like, these are beat. Yeah, they're starting to smell. I wear them so often. So that wraps up mine and your guys's top sneakers for 2018. Let me know what you guys want to see more from me. I'd love to hear from you guys. So leave a comment down below what videos you want to see, styling videos, lookbooks, hauls. What do you guys want to see? I just want to know. Thanks again for supporting me. So yeah, if you guys like this video, then give it a thumbs up. Leave a comment down below, subscribe, do whatever the fuck you want to do, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye.